as a world and as a nation, we have been through some very, very difficult times. And it's just so encouraging now that our church has become a vaccine centre. I was so moved in my heart when I saw John's WhatsApp. It really did make me think, what a great thing we are doing for the community. And I was so proud and so honoured to know that actually we can provide that for the community. And the next day I looked at a car. Well, it was a van actually. And I was behind that van and I was driving to work. And I looked. And what did I see? I saw an address. Obviously, it's where the van was from. It was from that depot. And that depot was situated in Hope Lane. Hope Lane. And you know what? I thought to myself, that accurately describes really where we are at the moment. We're on this lane or road, and it's called Hope. With the vaccines being rolled out every day at the pace in which they are, we are actually hoping that we can be together again as a church, as a community, and as a nation, and as a world. We can start to interact the way that God wants us to interact again. But have you ever sat down and thought, what can God do right now? What can he do before we get there? Do you find it difficult when you're at home? Do you sit there and think of the day that we will be able to meet up again? Well, may I encourage you, God can meet us exactly where we are. You only have to read John chapter 17 to see how deep the communion between Jesus and his Father was when there was no one else around. And the Bible actually encourages us to go into a private place and pray. And then when we pray in that private place, God will reward us openly. So what am I trying to say? God can be found right now. God can encourage you. And God can keep you on this journey, on this lane. Your heart may be filled with hope now, where before we didn't have a vaccine. Before, it seems we were waiting for that vaccine to come. What speed it was brought to us. I'm so pleased that we have scientists in this world that can do what they can do. And I honestly believe that God gave them the mind to be able to do it. So as we look into the future, let's hold on to two things. Jesus said he is the true vine and we are the branches. We can feed from him. We can get life from him when we're at home, on our own, at work. It's an internal experience. And as we go forward into this new summer that's coming, hopefully, I don't know when, could be summer, I don't know the exact dates, it always changes, but hopefully we can get to that place where we can worship God together. And I'm sure there are so many conversations that will be happening. Conversations, obviously, of thanksgiving, appreciation, and yes, there will be other conversations where people have been so affected, and it's good to be able to come together and to actually talk through certain things together as people and as a church. And I know myself that I have been affected in different ways by this outbreak and everything that happened. I've had positive things happen, and also I've had negative things happen. But one thing I wanted to say and testify is that God has been an absolute rock during all these times. God can be your rock. Call upon him and he will help you through these times. There is our thought of the day for this day. It's a beautiful day that I'm recording today, and I'm hoping that when we get back together again, the sun will be shining upon us.